morning.
How are you doing?
Good. What are you doing today?
I think I need to clean my truck.
Oh.
It's kind of filthy, so I figure I'd grab the old vacuum and a little EcoFlow power system.
Oh, okay.
And get her done, because it's about time to travel.
Well, it's getting kind of warm, so I can take the electric blanket and unplug it. I'm done with that now.
Do you want some coffee?
Sure.
I'm going to have coffee first before I do anything.
Okay.
Thanks for doing the filming for me, but I am sorry for pulling you from your electric blanket.
It was nice and toasty this morning, but the sun came out and it got a little warm in here, so I was ready to...
Help me out here?
Yeah, oh, I was ready to get out of the electric blanket.
It's been nice having the power system.
You should tell them what we are using, though.
Anyways, I figured I would do this before I go out and vacuum the car with this EcoFlow Delta 2 solar power system. So this is an upgraded power system from EcoFlow. It is a 1800 watt inverted power system. What it has is a 1024 watt hour battery inside. Nice light little system, weighs about 26 pounds, very powerful. And let me kind of show you a few things about it before I do go out and vacuum my truck. Anyways, easy power switch, real nice monitoring system. You can see I've used it a bit and everything. It's at 56%. And so what you have right up here are you have two USB-A ports. Over here, two USB-A fast charge ports. Two of them, one on each side here. A WBC 100 watt port. To turn those on, you just hit the button real quick. Now these are all activated.
You don't hold the buttons in.
No.
On some of these... You hold the button in, and this morning when I was trying to get it to go, I had a little problem because I didn't realize it. So it took me a minute to
gotta push it fast is all you do. Yep.
Yeah. You, some of these you kind of hold in and have to wait.
We learn about them all.
I like the quick release.
I like
that.
I
don't know if that's what you call it, but it's I like it better.
And this thing is pretty lightweight. So,
yep, I like that too.
This system, you can pair another system to it. So you can hook two of these together. And here's where you would hook the two together, your extra power port, to hook to another one. So you could stack them, which is really getting nice on all this stuff anymore to get more power. Anyways, on this side, what you have is you have your XT60 plug-in, and this is where you would either charge it with your solar system or you would use the car plug-in. The thing, if you use the car plug-in, it only charges at like a little over 100 watts, 125 watts an hour, so pretty slow. Now, if you use your household 110 right here, this thing will charge at about 1200 watts an hour. So basically in 1 hour, this thing can be completely dead and recharge up. This is your breaker right here in case it trips. And down here, we have 6 110 volt AC plugins. And again, just hit the button real quick. Lights right up. Down here, you have your DC port for your regular plug-in, and then you have two DC ports right here.
What's nice about the car charger is we do that a lot. We bring our battery generators up front, and we charge them as we're cruising.
Well, because also...
And I can plug in, I can work, I can do all kinds of stuff. It's kind of nice.
Yep.
Do that quite a lot.
So obviously EcoFlow sent this to us, and we do appreciate it. Now it's time to take it out and plug it into my... vacuum and clean my truck.
That's a mighty vacuum you have, I will say.
It unfortunately, I can't use it. I can't plug it into the house because my inverter won't take that super surge.
Yep.
So this thing has up to 2700 watts, according to what I'm reading, of that instant pulse. So if it kicks it on, I'm really happy. I don't even know what the vacuum takes because I always have to use my little generator to vacuum.
So I might throw you off a little bit, but can I ask you a question? Because I read these questions like on Facebook. Women, especially women, are trying to figure these things out. I don't understand the watt hours and everything, but like a lady had a question the other day, and she said, "I have an 1800 1800, which is, this is, right? 1800 watt. And I'm running my rice cooker, but that it doesn't seem to be. I think I told you because I was trying to figure out how these work.
Of all these numbers.
Yeah. I'll Can you explain you. That okay. if somebody is watching that does not understand this? Because it's not actually 1800 watt hours. Right.
Right. Okay. Exactly. So this system here is an 1800 watt system. So, but it has a 1024 watt hour battery. That's the power system in it. So basically, if you had a system that took 1000 watts, it would run it for an hour. If you had a system like Terry's Blanket that runs at 100 watts an hour, you're going to get 10 hours out of it. So those are kind of the numbers. Some things kick on, which we're going to, I think, when we do dinner later tonight, we're going to use the air fryer.
Oh, yeah.
I think the instant part of that is like 900 watts to turn on. And if I remember right, I think it goes to 600 watts as it cooks. So that kind of gives you an idea. And also on the front of this, it will, when you're taking the power, when you're sucking power out, it's going to tell you how much time you have left by the percentage you have on the chart right here. So I don't know if I have anything to plug in real quick. You know what? Should I try my ice maker?
No, it would not empty. Be a battery generator video if he didn't try let's plug in his ice maker. He wanted to do this a little bit ago, and I said, you know, I think you've kind of burnt out the ice maker part. He loves his ice maker. If you guys watch us, you all know this. So.
Well, and we've had other units that were close to the 1800 watt, and this thing hits such a surge when it kicks on the refrigerator part, just like your AC does, that it would stall out. So I got power.
This would not run an AC, even if you were in a van and wanted to run. Now, could you run a small fan off of this,
absolutely.
I wonder?
Okay. Anything, it'll run anything under 1,800 watts.
Okay.
Because you don't want to max it out.
And another thing is, like the rice cooker that I was talking about, I just keep going back to that because that was a question that I saw a gal ask.
Yeah.
Somebody had said, heating is one thing. Anything that has to be heated, right, is different.
If you're making heat, you're using a lot of power. If you're making cold, you're using a lot of power. If you're spinning a fan motor or something, you're really not using much power.
Okay.
That's kind of why, like, when you hit your blow dryer,
it surges.
It goes real hard because it's heating the air.
Right, okay.
We're making ice here. This is more important than blow drying hair.
Okay, my power's on. He loves his ice maker, you guys.
So let's see what it does. Let's just watch, and you'll see that it'll come on, and it'll cycle. It takes a second for it to do its thing, because I am curious about this.
They need to build an ice maker that's got one in there so that you can have one unit, all one unit. Okay,
solar operated. So now I just watch and see what happens, and you'll see how it hits hard. It's pumping the water now, so it's not going to register. Here comes the cooler part.
Okay. There it goes.
And what did it say? Did you see how it said 950 to kick
something
on?
Something like that. See? Yeah, I don't have my glasses on, but okay, I see.
And so that's the hard part, the shocker. Now, if you take the numbers and it uses 150 watts an hour to get to 1,000, I think you could run it for 6-7 hours.
Okay.
All right. Right around 7 hours, it would run my ice maker.
So hopefully, if you're watching the video and you guys had a question about the wattage versus the watt hours, maybe that helps a little bit. I still get really confused about it.
Well, you could have something that could be really small that has a lot of oomph in it, and you hit your air conditioner on, it would run it.
Yeah.
But unless it has the battery bank to it, it's not going to run it very long.
Right.
So this has a lot of oomph. With 1,000 watt hour supply of power.
Okay.
And it's a lithium ion battery in here.
Yeah, and I agree. Well, this one I can carry around. And if you turn it around here.
Yeah, let me unplug it.
Okay.
I
want to show you guys something because I have a hard time kind of lifting some of these up. Some of them get very heavy. I mean, you're lifting up a battery. But the way that EcoFlow has designed this, can you turn it this way?
And it has nice rubber on the bottom, so you can see it doesn't slide around.
Oh, you know what? And feel that. I didn't notice that.
Yeah.
So if you put it up against the wall, you're not...
Exactly.
I see. Yep, well, it's soft. Yep. Look, you've got handles on both sides.
Yep.
So it just makes it easier for someone that's, you know, has a harder time lifting things up.
And it's nice. Thin.
Yeah. All right. So you haven't been able to use your little vacuum. I call it your mighty vacuum. It's for the price we paid for that thing, it's mighty.
Anyways, he
hasn't been able to use it because, like he said, our
it has to run off the generator.
Yeah.
And believe it or not, truth be told, I've been to the store several times and I get fuel for the truck and I keep forgetting to put my gallon of gas in my gallon gas can.
So then these always come in handy. Absolutely. Too that way. Let's see how Scotty's doing in here. How's it doing?
Fabulous.
Wow.
I don't know how much power it's sucking, but it's running good.
Let's see one side. Let's see. Yeah. Okay, well, it says, I don't have my glasses on. Here they are. Hang on. 51% battery left.
How many watts?
506, 590, 92,
yeah,
91.
So 600 watts?
Yeah, I guess.
So it'll run this for almost 2 hours if it was all charged.
Wow.
Here's the best part is that it's the shock that the house won't take.
Yeah.
The little generator, which is a 2,000
nice
watt generator. Huh?
That's nice and pretty down there on my side. Thank you.
Oh, you kept it pretty clean. I found more of Pumpkin's dog food.
Oh, did you? Yeah, yes. She stores it in here. Now it's all in the vacuum.
But it's the shock factor, you know? The house won't run it.
Yeah.
Because when it hits the inverter, my inverter shuts down.
Right.
But this
982.
It's all that shock factor
right
that gets
it. But it seems to do it just fine.
All right, got the truck all cleaned up. Now I got some sun out here. So I have the 220 watt bifacial solar panel hooked up. It's putting 180 watts back into the... Let me show you what the difference is here. Look on this side. So it gets reflective light and helps charge this side. And these are little hangers. What you can do is you just can hang it up wherever you want it, either way. With a nice carrying case, protective case, to keep this in. And with the ability for this machine to take in 500 watts of solar, you can add to these MC4 connectors and add more solar. All right, guys, I hope I kind of helped explain how the power wattage works on these machines. Right now, EcoFlow is having a Black Friday sale. This is the lowest price of the year. So go check them out. And Terry's going to have information down below in the description area. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.